engine swaps are not uncommon when it comes to trying to extract maximum performance from a given chassis. However, some engine swaps potentially a little bit more controversial than others. And behind me, we've got the Castle Hill Performance built RX3 that's currently sporting a twin turbo big block Chev. Now, with close to 3,000 flywheel horsepower, it's fair to say that the typical 13B might struggle to produce this sort of power level. This car is built for the 275 Radial class here in Australia, where it runs on the 8th mile. It's run as quick as a 4.26 at 182 mile an hour on the 8th, making it currently the Australian champion. Now, while it doesn't normally do duty on the full quarter, it has run as quick as a 6.7 at 211 mile an hour in a slightly less tuned format. And when this car was first assembled, it was fitted with the more common LS engine swap. This has been swapped into just about any chassis you could now think of. But with aims of 3,000 horsepower in mind, even using the best of componentry and a cast iron block, it was proving to be difficult to get reliability out of the LS. The engine itself displaces 560 cubic inches, or if you prefer to work in metric, that's about 9.2 litres. The heart of the engine starts with a Crower crankshaft. This is a stroker crankshaft with a 9.25 inch stroke. It's connected to a set of BME alloy rods and pistons. Moving up to the cylinder heads, the engine's fitted with a pair of CID heads that are fitted with titanium valves. It's got Jesel rocker gear, and the valves are actuated via a Crow cam. While it's not necessarily a must-have in drag racing circles, the original LS that was fitted to this engine bay was dry-sumped, so the dry-sump system was retained for the big block Chev engine. This makes sure that regardless of the amount of G-force being pulled on the launch, a constant supply of high-pressure oil is always available to keep all of the engine components in optimum health. Well, the engine's there to support the airflow in and out and obviously hold together under around about 3,000 horsepower of strain, it's really the turbochargers that are the key to making the sort of power the engine is producing. In this case, a pair of 98mm Gen 2 precision turbos have been fitted, with boost being controlled via a pair of Turbosmart external wastegates. Boost control in this instance is handled via the Haltech Elite 2500 ECU, and this is also controlled using CO2 air pressure. Moving on to that Haltech ECU, this is the heart of the electronic control system here. It's in charge of all of the functions of the engine, including the fuel and ignition timing. In particular here, given the thirst for fuel that this engine has, it's really essential to run staged injection with two injectors per cylinder. Now, this means that the engine idles and runs under low power levels on one set of injectors, and the Haltech Elite stages in the second set as the RPM and boost climb and the engine's demand for fuel increases. Now, in order to control 16 injectors here in a staged fashion, this actually requires the Haltech REM or race expansion module. Now, not only does this provide outputs for an additional 8 injectors, it also provides some other race-only functionality, in particular the torque management aspect. Now, this car was actually used as the guinea pig for prototyping that race expansion module, so this is the first car in the world that ever ran the REM. Now, the torque management aspect is a type of traction control in essence. What it allows the ECU to do is monitor the drive shaft speed as the car goes down the drag strip. Now, obviously, as the car goes down the drag strip, the drive shaft speed is going to be increasing. And if there is any wheel spin, we're going to end up with that drive shaft speed spiking. So inside of the Haltech Elite software, a optimum pass can be set in terms of drive shaft speed versus time from the time the car is launched. And what this means is that if the drive shaft speed spikes above that optimal drive shaft speed line, the car is deemed to be wheel spinning, and the ECU can then use ignition card or ignition retard in order to manage that. This is really important, particularly on a car that is potentially a little bit undertired or on a track that's maybe not perfectly prepped, in order to make sure the car can go down the track every time. Particularly in this radial class, the class is very competitive. So it's not just about getting getting PBs every pass. It's about making sure that you beat the person in the other lane. Backing up that big block Chev and making sure all of that 3,000 horsepower makes its way to the rear of the car is a Turbo 400. Now, the Turbo 400 transmission in stock form is typically a 3-speed. However, this has been modified into a 2-speed. Now, quite often we see a lot of competitors with automatic transmissions in these sort of classes running the common Power Glide, which is a 2-speed. The reason for going here with the Turbo 400 and converting to a 2-speed is that it is much stronger. There's a lot more room internally, and particularly the input shaft through the transmission is much larger, making it more capable of handling the extra power this engine is producing. Once the power has made its way through that Turbo 400, it's sent rearward to a Ford 9-inch that's fitted to the rear of the car. That 9-inch is a ladder bar setup. Both ladder bar and four-link rear end setups are common in drag racing circles, both with their pros and cons. Arguably, the ladder bar setup is a little bit easier to get dialed in, and given that this car will pull a 112 60-foot time, it's certainly no slouch out of the hole. Now, while you might not be in love with the idea of a big block Chev fitted to an RX3, there's no way you can argue that this is one fast Mazda.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.